I'm Danforth Prince, president of Blood Moon Productions, and I'm very happy to be on the floor of the New York Gift Show interviewing Mr. John Groton, the NBN's new director of sales. It's a great honor that he is here. It shows a huge commitment on the part of the NBN to a new management style of plugging sales forward. I think it's a very tricky thing, the concept of sales for a publisher, for any publisher. I am a publisher. I am a client of the NBN. All of us are such type A personalities, all of us salesmen. We develop our books, but when it comes to sales, we become proprietary, we become demanding, we really, really want to look at who will be directing the sales affecting our livelihoods, the future of our books, blah, blah, blah. And it's because of this that I'm really very grateful that, John Groton, the new director of sales for the NBN, has agreed to be interviewed here at the New York Gift Show. A couple of words about the NBN's commitment to the Gift Show. It's one new outlet for books that is not the automatic assumption of a lot of people in the old publishing scenarios. It used to be that books were sold in brick and mortar bookstores. It was very simple. You went to the bookstore, you bought a book. In this economy, though, there's more emphasis on electronic books and on gift books. That's why we are here. John, it's a pleasure to see you. Welcome to your new job.
Well, thank you very much, Danforth. Pleasure to be here with you.
You have a rough job navigating this happy ship through what? Thousands of changes going on in the book business these days.
Contrary to that, I have a wonderful job. It's a very challenging job, but it's probably never been a more exciting time. That's my point of view, generally speaking, on the book business.
Blood Moon is devoted to getting all of its titles into the proper electronic format through the NBN's Fusion program.
Yes.
It's almost as if Blood Moon is gearing up for the battles to come, for the new venues to come, the new devices that are coming. We take this very seriously, but I think that's one of the fields into which you will expand your sales, your vision.
Absolutely correct. Absolutely correct.
A very interesting press release we publishers got from the NBN was a new link with retail stores, chains such as PetSmart and what was the other one?
Michaels.
Michaels, the craft stores, and NBN will be selling wholesale to Michaels craft outlets.
Right, through a major third-party distributor. Michaels, as far as selling books is concerned, it's nothing new, but what's most exciting about it is that they're now working with a wholesaler who is really exclusive to books, knows the book industry, knows the suppliers, meaning the publishers, and I think they're really setting themselves up to make that particular store operation a much more effective way to sell books.
Now, those will certainly be books mostly about crafts, I guess.
Well, there will be craft books, but there will also be a major children's book section in the store as well.
Oh, that's good. That's nice.
So when you think about the consumer going into a Michaels to purchase materials for making craft products, you want books there that will help you do that, of course, but also there's a lot of kids involved, and there's an opportunity, more probably on an impulse basis, to purchase children's books when it's properly merchandised in those types of stores.
And I think what I remember is that the sales to Michaels and to PetSmart will be funneled through Baker and Taylor. It was their account before.
Baker and Taylor is going to be the distributor that is taking over that responsibility. They've had, actually, PetSmart for a number of years.
Fascinating.
And they seem to be making a major push to bring other retailers into the fold, which I'm personally, as working for the distributor for many publishers, very excited about.
Are we ready and available for the multiplicity of new devices coming on the way?
Absolutely. I mean, we have now relationships with over 40 customers in the marketplace, so the obvious ones being the Kindles and the Nooks and the Sony readers of the world, and then other companies that maybe the general public is not as aware of, such as Scribd, Overlook, and companies like that. So what the Fusion program is all about is, first of all, taking all of those files and preparing them so they're ready to go out in whatever format those customers need, and then also our distribution relationships with those customers. And we are at such an early stage, of course, in this development, which has been getting so much press, more press about the book business than I have ever seen in the 30 years that I've been in it, which I think ultimately is a really good thing because it's bringing more attention to books. The real challenge for us as publishers and distributors working with these new customers is how we will bring the consumer to that book. So that's the next next one.
Marvelous.
It's one thing to sell a million Stieg Larsson novels in a Kindle format or whatever. It's a whole nother matter to take your upcoming Frank Sinatra book and do the same type of thing. We need to come up with strategies to bring consumers to whichever format they want, whether it's in print, whether it's electronic, whether you buy it in a gift store, or whether you buy it in a bricks and mortar bookstore.
How nice of you to talk about the Frank Sinatra book. That will be hot. We have a hot book on Frank Sinatra coming out in, I think, March. Anecdotes out the kazooie on this one, never before published. What about commissioned reps? There's two ways to have a salesman working for the NBN. One is an in-house employee. You can monitor him more closely. You can bang your fist more loudly. The other is to hire an outside organization to flow your books through. And any policy that you have at the NBN about whether you prefer in-house reps or trade groups on the outside?
Well, I think, first of all, we're very fortunate to have a number of terrific salesperson people, whether they are quote-unquote in-house or whether they are out on a commission basis. The way we're set up is that for our national accounts, such as Barnes & Noble and Borders and Amazon, Ingram, Baker & Taylor, we have our own people who are in-house, employed by our company
yes.
full-time. And then for independent bookstores and increasingly for the gift market, which Dennis, who you recently spoke with, is starting to expand that coverage for the National Book Network, those are also on a commission basis. So we are, you know, we're thrilled to have both our in-house as well as our commission groups working out there on our behalf.
So you're happy with the bifurcated, truncated, two-tier system?
Yeah. Oh,
that way.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Okay,
yeah. Yeah.
I was surprised at how many more reps there are in the gift trades than there are in the book trades.
Well, there's a lot of, I don't know what the count would be. Dennis would probably have a more accurate figure, but I think he told me that there's something about 11,000 accounts that he has had some communication with over the years, and we are rapidly building up to that number here at the National Book Network.
Is it?
And those are independent stores. These are not national chains like an Urban Outfitters or an Anthropology. That's a whole other part of the marketplace.
The question is about what a director of sales does. You are it's a tricky job. It involves the carrot and the stick. It involves beating the sales rep if he doesn't work. It involves encouraging him if he's discouraged. What do you do with a terminally depressed salesman if, God forbid, the lifestyle doesn't suit the salesman?
Well, fortunately, I don't think, after being here for a little more than 2 weeks, we have any terminally depressed salespeople. That's the good news.
Good, I'm delighted. And God bless them if that should befall them.
And,
you know?
And there are certainly challenges out in the marketplace, but that's also nothing new. The challenges may be different than they were 10 or 15 years ago, but nevertheless, there were obstacles before, there will be obstacles in the future. My role really is to look at each publisher's publishing program, look at it on a book-by-book basis, and then determine where we can maximize the sales for those books by the various and very diverse channels that we sell into. So we do sell to bricks and mortar bookstores that are independent. We do sell to Barnes & Noble and Borders. We sell to internet retailers such as Amazon, BN.com, Borders.com. But we also sell to major gift stores like Urban Outfitters and Anthropology. We sell to Costco. We sell to BJ's. We sell to Walmart. We sell to Target. The landscape is so diverse, but you have to be very careful where you place the product depending upon the type of book that it is
yes.
and the type of customer that you're selling to.
And incidentally, we, the publisher partners with the NBN, would be delighted at any time to tailor any of our upcoming books to correspond to a greater sales outlet if you would just tell us what to do.
Mm-hmm.
Take out the nude picture on page 75 and you suddenly open up all of, what, Costco to your particular title.
Well,
easy to do if all we need to do is know, you know?
Yep. Well, that's where the collaboration comes in between the distributor and the publisher.
You're still committed to having your twice-a-year sales meetings.
Mm-hmm.
Okay?
Yep.
And then you meet with your sales staff by telephone conference once a week, once a day?
We have a weekly meeting for our salespeople that I am now, of course, being new to National Book Network. Beginning to get involved with, and I'm going to start structuring that meeting in a way that I think is going to be most beneficial. So that may be similar to the way it's been, it may be changing in the future, but that's forthcoming. In fact, next week I will start that.
Good luck to you, John.
Well, thank you very much, Danforth. It's been a pleasure talking with you.
John Groton, the new director of sales of the National Book Network. I'm Danforth Prince from Blood Moon Productions, talking on the floor of the New York Gift Show, yet another way the NBN is working creatively to market books in an all-new environment called the Gift World. Thank you very much.